Hello, this is Yuantin from NVIDIA. Today, we're going to show you how to run Federated XGBoost with NVIDIA Federated Learning Framework, NVFLARE. A quick introduction on what is Federated Learning. In a typical machine learning paradigm, users gather all the available data into one machine and run the training program on top of it to find the best performing model, as shown in the left-hand side. However, in many machine learning use cases, for example, medical, financial industry, and companies that has worldwide sites that need to collaborate. Data owners cannot share their private data with each other or with third parties due to legal regulations or privacy concerns. Federated learning can be used to train a joint model without the need to aggregate data in a centralized location. As you see in the right-hand side, each data just stay on the site that produced them. What they're sharing here is just a model, weights or weights differences, and we can apply privacy preserving algorithms here, such as differential privacy or homomorphic encryption. Now let's go straight to today's demo. Today we are running Federated XGBoost with histogram-based tree construction. I have already set the system in a real-world scenario. One NVFLARE server and two NVFLARE clients. I set it up using NVFLARE provision system with NVFLARE version 2.4.1. As you can see here, my server is running on the cloud, my site one is running on the cloud, while the site one is running in my local workstation, and I'll be using my notebook to run an NVFLARE admin command line interface to interact with the whole system. So NVFLARE is a multi-job system. To train a model, we need to prepare a job first. I have prepared this XGB job here. Let's take a look at what's inside. So for a job, we will have app and then the meta. And inside the app, you will have the server-side config and the client-side config. And then in the custom folder, you can also put the code, put your customized folder that you need to run in there. So let's take a look at what's inside. For the server side, you will just specify this controller. Don't worry, we'll provide this job in our repo. So you'll need to remember it. You can just copy paste. And what we need to pay attention here is just these number of rounds that we can change it. And then these timeout intervals values that we'll go into details a little bit later. And for the client config, again, this long name, we don't need to memorize it. We just copy paste. And what we need to pay attention to is these values we can change. We can change the early stopping rounds or these XGB params that'll be passed onto the XGB trainer. So like max steps, eta or objective. And then again, these timeouts, we'll explain them in details a little bit later. And then in here, the data loader. Today in this job, we're using the Higgs dataset and with the first 10,000 rows, just for a demo. And then, so if you want to use your own dataset, you can just write your own data loader. And how can we do that? Let's take a look at it. It's pretty simple. So you just need to import the space class from here. And then you implement your own custom data loader, you know, to inherit the space class. What you need to do is that you implement this load data method that will return two XGBD matrix. One is for training and the other is for validation. As you see here, what we do here is just that we use pandas, the read CSV to read in the file. And then we just say, hey, xgb.dmatrix to construct these two matrices. Okay, now we have prepared our job that's connect to our system. So in here, I'm starting the admin CLI here. And let's wait a bit. Okay, it's prompting for the username. We can check status of the server. Okay, we see two site is connected, and then enter status of a client. You see right now, no job is running. You can list the job, so no job is running. Right now, we can just use submit job to submit this XGB job that we just prepared. Okay, so after we submit the jobs, you see here is the job ID. And when we list jobs, this exact job ID is running right now. And you can again check for the status of the server. And you see this job is running. You check status of the clients, and you see this job is running. Okay. Now this job is running. Let's go and explain some of these tunable parameters and timeout values that you might need to change for your own data and your own system, and based on your own like message size and then network speed. So what are these? The XGB params on the client. So client side config, you have the XGB params. Those are the parameters that you need to be passed to the XGB trainer. You have per message timeout. It's the timeout for each message. You have this transaction timeout that defines how long you want to keep retrying until this transaction is done. And on the server side config, you have this max client OP interval, which is the max amount of time permitted for a client to be silent. That means if this client exceed this interval that it didn't send anything back to the server, the workflow will consider this job is dead. And the progress timeout is similar to this. It's just that right now it's specified the maximum amount of time allowed for all clients to be silent. Okay, and let's take a look at this job is still running. Okay, so in real world scenario, there will be network outages, your network interruptions. And today we're gonna show you how our system will perform under that scenario. So we'll be using this command called IP tables to drop the connection from site 2 to server to simulate a network outage. And then after a certain amount of period, we will resume the connection to see if the job can still be running and run to completion. All right, that's check. Okay, finally, our first job is finished. Let's right now submit this exact same job. So we can then simulate the network outage. And at the same time, let me show you. This first two line is from the first experiment we just run. Okay. Now let's try to simulate the network outage. Yep, so this command is the command we just run. So that means the site 2 and server right now is not connected anymore. We can check status server. And you see here the site 1's time, it keeps updating while the site 2's time is not updated because server, you know, the connection is dropped. And then we can check status of client and see right now the site 2. It shows no reply. That means, you know, the network has some interruptions there. Okay, and we can use this IP tables command again to resume it. So after we resume it, we should be seeing that, you know, if we check status server, the last connect time should be the latest one. And if we check status of client, the site 2 should show that, okay, right now I am resuming running the same exact job. Let's see if it is the case. Okay, we might need more time for it to bring back online. Let's see. 53. Oh, okay. You see? Right now, both our site 1 and site 2, they are updated to the latest time here. And then if we check the status of the client, we'll see both of them are running this job. So that proves our system is not affected by this short-term network outage. And we can take a look at here. So you see the second experiment just keeps going. We can wait for a little bit here. So you see it's okay. Right now it's actually finishing. Yep, it finished and it completed. So you see here, okay, it ran all 100 rounds. So that proves our system is resilient to this network interruption. So that wraps up for today's episode. If you have any questions regarding setting up your Federated Learning Systems or how Federated XGBoost works and details, please check out our NVFLARE GitHub repo. It is all open source, and our members are actively monitoring the issues and discussions there. So feel free to drop any questions or comments there. We will see you in the next episode.